All right, we're live. What's up, everybody? G Mr. Drew here to welcome you to another episode of the Andrew Gloszewski Experience. It's going to be episode 341, I believe. Man, we're gonna let's continue where we left off, doing these Bayonetta concept studies, going through systematically figuring out all these beautiful designs by Marie Shimazaki. I hope that's how you pronounce it. I don't know. And going through all of these one by one, and we're currently working on this one. So, as you can see, I got my marker ready. I'm just gonna throw down some of the light colors. Don't have too much time, so it's gonna be like kind of partial. I'll probably leave the main body of the suit uncolored, but we'll get in the let's get some of the blonde and the ivory and the skin done at the very least. And yeah, man.
Dating a girl for a while now. The other day she said to me, she was like, "Cody, I don't think you're autistic. I think you just need to stop telling me fun facts about killer whales." Kind of annoyed me because she knows they're called orcas. Fun fact. There was one night, right before sex, she put a Starburst in her mouth and she unwrapped it with her tongue. And she pulled out the wrapper. She was like, "Pretty sexy, huh?" "I love when you pull trash out of your mouth." Wow, there it is. Performance. We had punchlines, setups, the whole thing that you would have expected from everybody else all night tonight. But here we are. Really, really, really incredible. You wore your best bus driver pants to be here tonight.
There we go.
What the fuck are those, dude? What's going on over there?
God, they're my work pants. My work
What do you
pants.
do for work?
I can't say.
Are you a
Yes,
customer at a
sir.
movie?
Fire me. I can't say.
You're a postman, right?
No.
No. He said no, he's totally not a postman, everybody. That makes sense. You had great delivery here today, very crisp and yeah, stupid. I love it. All right. So you're a young postman, not for the US Postal Service, but obviously for another company altogether.
Yep.
Right, totally. And how long you been doing that?
Like about a month.
Okay.
Not yeah, a month.
Wow, congratulations. That's a fucking pretty cool job, right?
It's fun. People love. Oh God, I can't talk. People love you. Yeah, I'll say that.
People
People
love you.
Are so nice. Yeah,
and when
you're
you're
very nice. Yeah,
right.
exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. How about dogs?
All
Do dogs love
right.
you, dude? What's the deal with dogs and postmen?
I don't know. It's I think it's the
Do you
sound.
have a fun fact about that? Like
I
why?
do. I
Okay.
It's the sound of the truck. I swear to God, they don't like that. Yeah.
Right. That weird sliding door you guys have is weird. Huh, interesting. Okay. Was that your girlfriend that you said about the Starburst thing? You really have a girlfriend?
I do, yeah.
Yeah. How far did you drive to be here tonight?
I'm originally from Boston.
Boston. Wow, okay. So about 14-hour drive. All right,
cool.
Where do you live now?
Pflugerville.
Pflugerville. Pflugerville. Pflugerville. Pflugerville. All right, I love it. For those of you just listening to the podcast that don't know, Pflugerville is like if South Park was in Austin. There's a bunch of people shaped like Red Band and this guy all wearing hats out there.
Yes, ooh, how are you? Ooh, how's it going today? Ooh, a little bit of that ice on the bridge today. It's wild living out here. All the postmen's a new. We got a new young white boy.
Talk Germans.
You role play stuff?
could become a permanent castmate on the show if you win a drum solo competition. Oh, shit. How long you been playing drums for, Cody?
Like, I don't know, 13 years!
Well, then I guess we are going to have to do a Mexican drum off, everybody. Here, live, tonight. This is one of those moments where maybe you don't know, but if you don't know, you're about to fucking know. The history of this show is one filled with rich moments of people trying their hardest to win a drum solo competition against the resident drummer, formerly living legend, Mexican Joel Jimenez, current reigning defending champion, Mexican Michael Gonzalez. But here he is, getting his position, Cody Green, 13 years of drumming experience. Now let me remind all of you that you get to decide who wins at the end of this. Never before has a visitor won this competition. It's probably 35-0, always in favor of the resident drummer. But if he does win, Cody becomes the new, every week, full-time drummer here on the show. Which it seems like a drumming comedian would like. And if Michael Gonzalez loses, he has to become a postman in Pflugerville. So they have to switch.
There we go. Have I been off camera?
Actually, he sort of looks like he could be a Pflugerville postman. You might be built for this. Yeah. He's been running away from Chihuahuas his whole life, this guy. So.
All right. Let's see. How does this?
One of the highlight segments on the history of the show. This is the Mexican drum off. This is Cody Green, everybody. Here we go.
All right, let's just get these out of the way right now. And man, is the only skin on her her face? Holy shit. Wow, everything's covered. Okay.
Alright.
Probably going to be the main body of what I'm going to work on right now is just all the gold, all the gold stuff.
Should I pull till we get a girl out of here, huh? All right, let's see what happens.
Man, my yellow brush has just been super bloody lately. Alright, can I, like, leak some of this out? Like, yo. Like, the last few times I've used this thing. There we go. Now it's a little... Go.
I think OnlyFans. Oh, fuck. Okay. I used to be a whore for the love of the game, and now I've just gone corporate. Fucking sucks. Decent save. I think OnlyFans is the female version of joining the army.
Man, this picture's already starting to come together, man. I'm really liking this. Sorry I'm being so quiet, man. I'm watching Kill Tony in the background. And really just kind of under the gun with time. But I figured I'd get a stream in, get some work done. And, you know, hey, man, it is what it is. I be trying.
People to get their eyes on me, but it doesn't make me any money in the long run. It's better to make my own content.
you're working, you sort of have to do, you know, I believe it or not, I do watch porn with women in it, everybody. And I see what they do, right? You hang out for a second, you start blowing him, standing, and then he lays you down, goes down on you, and then shoves it in, and then missionary, and then doggy style, and then however the big finish is, and then, like, Mexican fireworks.
Are you sure you watched porn before? Like,
I'm just trying to, I just replaced one of the guys with a woman in this story that I'm describing. No, I'm kidding. Let me ask you this. Is there anything you do in real life in the bedroom that's different than something you would do in a porn scene? Is there something you specialize in? Like, perhaps a upside down 69 or something like that? I don't know. Like a standing 69 where you hold the boy up like that and suck his dick. Upside down, all the blood rushes to his head.
Hans would let you do it to him.
Hans would let you do it to him.
There we go.
You'll just have to squirt a little bit of Lubriderm in your mouth. Because you can only come if there's Lubriderm involved now. You do anything weird in the bedroom? You have any special finishing moves like your Stone Cold Stunner or Tombstone Pile Driver or anything like that?
Tombstone Pile Driver, wow.
I feel like I don't. Everything's more chill in my personal life than in work. But I like hooking up with guys for like the first time because they've never fucked tits that big.
Right.
So like.
So you always like give them a little bit of the stick
yeah,
in between
like,
the boobs.
Yeah.
Right. You have to.
Yeah.
Now, do most guys survive that? How long do guys last in that situation?
I've had pros go over.
Whoa. Hell yeah. Those fucking nutcrackers up there, dude. You got those fucking Dairy Queens. Those fucking milk bags. Those fucking honeycombs. Jesus, when you bounce them like that, it's really amazing. When you do that, it makes my back hurt.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right.
Oh, Jesus Christ. It is the season, is what this lady just put together with her brain and words and mouth. Tis the season, bitch, to be shaking your fucking triple Z tits that you have. What is the size of those again? What do we call that?
M for Molly.
Wow, it really is an M. Oh my god. M for fucking.
Everybody's high.
Oh my god.
Alright.
You're such an interesting person. Benji, have you ever seen the type of porn star like this? Benji lives in the Los Angeles, Beverly Hills area. I don't think he's ever dealt with anyone that plays La Loteria.
No, I have a lot of questions.
Okay.
Go ahead, ask some questions.
Okay, well, the stuff you do on OnlyFans, is it just you or you recruit guys from Austin to be on camera with you?
I can do that, and I have done that, but I usually just... It's so much easier to just rely on myself. I'm the only talent, and I have like a built-in fan base, so no matter what I post unedited or whatever, they just fucking buy it. It doesn't really matter.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a lot of guys out there that are into chicks that are shaped like a grape, so it's perfect.
Lots of food records.
Yeah.
Apple grape.
Yeah, you guys really left me hanging on that one. Thanks a lot, folks. It became more insulting if you didn't laugh like we're at a comedy show.
Love me, Tony.
All right. I love that. A lot of people don't know this, but they found Molly's porn on the iPad of Bob Saget in that hotel room last night. That's the type of...
It's an honor.
See tits like that, and...
You know, Molly, I would love to have you on the Secret Show Thursday if you can.
Whoa! Wow! Look at that! We found a way to get booked by Red Band, everybody. M-sized tits. Hell yeah.
There was a girl last week that sized K and didn't play
that. She got booked on that. Yeah.
Did you ever do your scratchers on your OnlyFans and like make $30? And...
That's a really good idea.
Do you ever do your scratchers like, on your tits? Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, you have to like shake your tits so that you can dangle a little. I don't know, we'll work on it, alright? It's the first draft, fuckos.
If you won a bunch of money on your OnlyFans, that'd be, like, pretty exciting.
But they also might be like, well, fuck, we're not giving her money anymore.
Oh, right.
But I'll give her, like, the $3 scratch-off. should be more like million stretch marks.
Yeah, that is a good roast joke for you. That is really good. That's good. That's how I do it, too. I like to think of the best jokes for me first. Like, everything David Lucas has said, I wrote down in my diary this morning. It's going to be a long day today, as I'm looking like a unicorn gay boy. Good luck to your booty on this day.
When you're doing your laundry, like three bras and the washer's full, and then you just gotta...
Molly, the washer's on fire again! Did you put one or two bras in there? It's like the sound of a million coins over and over. Sounds like a corn song. Bras, I love it. I mean, that is just incredible. Not a lot of people know this, but her bras are made out of, you know what, I didn't think of anything funny to say. Every once in a while, I'll do an exercise in my own brain where I'll do the setup, and I'll be like, you'll get it, and then, nothing. Every once in a while, Tom Brady throws a fucking interception. You know what I'm saying? Alright.
Do your fans ever buy you bras? Or is that something okay? Because I know they get you a bra. It's not good.
There we go.
Sears.
Little bits of color. God damn, this picture's so big. I wonder if my camera's like creeping in or something. Darker colors. Let's get this red jewel out of the way. Am I right?
Come on, people, make some noise for William! The first time I heard Molly did porn, I looked her up on Pornhub that evening and can confirm she does do porn.
Are we blurry? Are we not? I don't know.
Back in my day, you had to go to the woods to find a Switch. Nowadays, all you gotta do is call Nintendo. If y'all can laugh really hard at my grandfather's saying these jokes, I'd really appreciate it. My wife is so hot, Viagra takes me instead. Okay, guys, keep laughing. I need this. Grandpa needs this. Hey kids, what's scarier than a Japanese guy in a plane? A Japanese pilot with his eyes open. Well, Grandpa, now that the war's over, Nintendo's a Japanese company, for God's sake. Okay, that's all I got tonight.
Wow, I love it. That's a new fucking delivery method right there. Wrote a set for your grandfather.
Yeah, Mississippi, my dad and uncle have to give them money every month.
Wow. Why is that? What did he do? He retired without the...
Yeah, I think he retired in like his 40s.
Oh, wow.
Yep, and my parents have to give him money every month, and it's a constant thing of contention in the Montgomery household.
Wow. What do they say? Like, do an impression of your father having to realize that he has to give Vicksburg,
Oh, you know what?
I missed
the medallion. Let's get that real quick.
Yeah, it's a pretty good account. That's about what it is every time.
It's pretty spot on.
That's about what it is every time.
Wow. I love it. William, you look more chiseled. You've been losing weight. You stopped drinking 6 months ago. You went home for the holidays and came back with a well-trimmed beard and haircut. Your parents forced you to do that, am I correct?
Yes, my mom did.
Right. What did she say? She said, William, you have to get it together.
She said, Francis, I am sick. I'm kidding. I was about to say what I had already said. I have been gaming a whole bunch this week. I literally can't stop.
There we go.
Playing PlayStation 4 and The Last of Us and The Last of Us 2. And now I'm going to the Ghost of Tsushima.
Okay.
I can't stop fucking playing. I'm going to leave here and immediately start playing again.
It's true. He literally does this all the time. He plays video games now and eats soup and walks around with an unregistered gun.
I do. I have fucking an extra one tonight in my trunk. I have 3 fucking guns in my trunk tonight! Yeah.
Go get these...
Yeah, let's just say don't be near the Tesla Outback when he fucking gets in it. Because there's going to be some fireworks tonight.
Whoa! What? Now, this rivalry with Red Band, we've seen it now for weeks to months. Always a little energy. Last week, William tried to make amends with Red Band. He said that he wants to bury the hatchet and put out his hand to shake it. And William had one of those shocker things in his hand. And Red Band clenched so hard his hips that he literally broke the iron of the chair that he's sitting on right off its hinges.
There we go.
He sort of fell, it was all floppy.
You guys know the soccer, right? Like the ones who wind up there, you're like, how is this ever going to work with somebody? It fucking works.
That's what I was saying.
For like an hour afterwards, I had this like ghost pain or something in my hand. I was just like, what's wrong with my hand?
It's one of those well-executed pranks I've seen in my entire life. It's
for real.
So old school, nobody saw it coming. And you really took the rivalry to a new level. I thought that it was going to be the end. I thought you truly wanted to bury the hatchet, and instead, you hit the back. regularly. Two years ago,
he made a pass at me. And I haven't fucking forgotten.
What kind of pass did he make?
I was over at his house, and I was changing clothes in his closet, and he comes in there and asks if he can help put my boxers on, and I say, get out, Red Band. He's like, no, come here. And I did, and he tried to kiss me, and...
I didn't try to kiss him.
Yeah, you did kiss me.
Yeah, I know.
Wow.
I was embarrassed to fucking say you actually did it. Yeah, you actually made out with me in the closet. Yeah.
You put his tongue in your mouth?
Yeah, and I kind of reciprocated. I honestly kind of liked it, and I started texting him a bunch and calling him a bunch, and he basically said, quit contacting me. Basically, and that's honestly what hurts, right, man? That's where all this fucking started.
You wanted to be your lover, dude.
I got a girlfriend. You gotta be cool. You can't just be fucking texting and calling me all day, right? You gotta hide this shit.
Well, now I know, Red Band. Now I fucking know.
I told you to download Signal, man.
Well, I didn't fucking download Signal.
You know I'm not gonna download Signal.
William, if you had a chance to make slow love to Red Band, what would be the first thing you would do to him?
All right. Let's see. If I wanted to do one last pass with some light colors.
I would kiss him a little bit in his belly button.
You would kiss him in his belly button?
Yeah, kiss him in his belly button a little bit. I would go down to his toes, kiss his toes a little bit.
Oh, shit.
He likes that. I don't know if y'all like that, but he likes toes shit. He's fucking weird as shit. He likes foot stuff. It's fucking weirds me out, but I'd be willing to kiss his toes and slowly do my hands up underneath his armpits, tickle him a little bit. He's real ticklish. Maybe kiss on his nipple a little bit.
Whoa. You say his nipple like he only has one?
He only actually does have one nipple. I don't know if y'all know that.
Wow.
It's like a birth defect.
A lot of foreplay here with you and Ray.
Yeah, Cameron. It's a lot of foreplay. I don't know exactly what else to say. I've dug myself into a hole. This is a mistake. Bad mistake.
I don't think it was. I think it was hilarious.
Yeah, I was wondering how far to take that. I was wondering about talking about his penis or my penis, but then it scared me, and I thought maybe it wouldn't be funny, and yeah, it's a mistake.
Right.
I never should have started it.
All right.
Here we go. Just try to tighten up these little bits.
It got real cold the other night. I had a fern out on the patio, and I brought the fern in, and out of my periphery, I saw this black object. It turned out it was a bird, but it scared me to death when it flew out, and I'm glad I had my Crocs on, or I would have broken my fucking toes on the side of my bed when I ran out of the fucking bedroom.
Wait, there was... Wait a second. Wow, Red
Band. Who did that fucking noise? What at all, Red?
Yeah.
Who did that fucking noise?
Yeah, that was Red Band that did that to you.
God. God.
Listen to the noise he made when he was mad at Red Band.
God.
Wait, so there was... Hold on a second. There's a black bird in your house?
Yeah, I was in the house for a couple of hours. I had my towels out trying to get it out of the balcony, trying to get it out of the room.
How did it get in there?
It was in the fern. It was living in the fern. It was a sweet little finch.
You brought a tree in that had a black bird in it.
Yeah, a little fern.
Okay.
Where the fuck is she going? I'm having the set of my fucking life right now, and some bitch is getting up to fucking walk off. The fuck is going on? Thank you.
go.
Matt Meowling on guitar, Pete Madness on the bass, John Beans on the keys, and coming off a fresh win tonight, the great Michael Gonzalez on drums. La Loteria. We did it again. Fun times here in Austin, Texas. All these shows are sold out for the Visible Future. All
right. Now.
And Red Band, anything else?
William.
And just get some hair strands going, right? Basically, all I'm doing to get these things in is just making use of all the random lines, including these ink squares, framing everything. Just using everything that I have to, sorry, keep
go to Jam right now, jambb.com. You create your account, you'll be ready for it. And it's wild, like we're stepping into this.
I'm so excited, but what's an NFT?
Come on.
What?
It's a non-fungible token, you big animal.
Oh.
That's all you do. It's like these are like moments, you know, it could be an NFT.
It's like merch.
It's like merch. Digital merch. So
gotcha.
It could be clips, it could be stills, it could be music, sometimes they're, you know, with gaming, with art. This one is all in your mom's house. If you like NFTs, if you want to step into it, the packs start at $9, which is a great price. And if, again, create your account now, jambb.com, and it'll drop next week.
I'm a handsome woman, so that's the one.
That's right.
Just so you guys know, that joke is still going around. I like to say, even when I'm feeling down about myself. Like, we were having like a moment yesterday.
This episode of Your Mom's House is brought to you by Saatva, go to Saatva, SAATVA.com/the-ship, and get $200 off any mattress of your choice.
Yeah, that's a fetish.
know, that's a really good question. Hopefully we can find out before the episode's over.
I'd like to do that, Tom.
Yeah.
Would you do it?
Would I do my notes like that?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so. But I'd really support one of us back doing it. Yeah.
Well, Josh Potter was on his way when he had TikToks.
He had TikToks on regularly, and his tics were changing for sure.
I mean, my nips have changed from having babies.
Yeah.
Beyond them.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's only, what, 2 years of my life?
Yeah, but imagine getting grown men and having to put them coming on every day. Then your nips will change for sure.
Just imagine it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's a reason you stop breastfeeding once the babies get teeth.
Yeah, true.
But that guy, I think you have to chew them to get them.
You really have to, you have to do something to it. They're not just going to change like that.
The nipples don't get like that, but you got to work.
Yeah, you got to really work at your nipples. Pretty cool.
Yeah, what a cool guy.
Yeah.
Of course. Sorry, knocking the camera. Some of this face stuff.
That was California. Yeah, you're right. That was foreign. The first girl I saw that was in Spain.
I'm not fucking tell you, dude. Because
yeah.
So it's foreign. The European, aren't you European?
She was.
And they're nasty as hell. They do what they want.
She was a very nasty girl. And I.
German?
Yeah, yes, she was.
Are you being serious? You just fucking with me?
No.
I knew it. You already knew it. They're savages.
Yeah. There's also some savage Spanish girls. Some of those girls are really nasty, too.
Oh.
Yuck.
Do you know, I had a friend in high school.
There we go.
Here's Furness in 10th grade. 10th grade.
That girl would have been very popular in the circles I ran.
Yeah. And she had a boyfriend that was like 18 or 19. Mm-hmm. She was 15.
Yeah, that was like 2,000 for 15.
Yeah.
Once you get your message.
All right. And yeah, man, that's going to be it for this one. Spent a little more time than I wanted to, but fuck it. We got the hard part done, all these light colors. And on the next episode, we will continue this. Basically, black leather and like a mahogany type of leather. So, you know, black and red, essentially. And, yeah, that's going to be it. So I want to thank y'all for watching. I'm G Mr. Drew. It's at G Mr. Drew on all socials. Follow, like, and subscribe. All those links are in my bio with my website, gmrdrew.com. Or no, gmrdrew.art. What am I saying? And yeah, check out my website. Contact me through there if you want. And yeah, if you're interested in commissions or anything like that, check out my Patreon. You can hire me on Fiverr if you want illustrations, things like that. But yeah, let's call it quits on this one, man. Super liked it, and glad, dude. These ivory guns are super interesting. You know, like after drawing red guns forever and ever and ever, it's nice to like switch it up a bit. You know, these blonde bayos are super cool, and then this outfit is crazy. Can't wait to render it out. You can see there's like a lot of rendering that's gonna have to happen just because everything is so what it is. And yeah, man, once I'm done with this one, yeah, I guess I can maybe use these squares to try to jump in on something. I'm thinking I can throw the sleeve and throw like an alternate angle of the sleeve design in here so we can really see what the sleeves are doing. And yeah, but that's it, man. Another quick short one. Got all the light colors in. I hope you all enjoyed it. And yeah, man, thank you for watching. Love y'all. Peace.